Please pray with me. Father, thank you for this day of celebration. May everything we say and do today bring you glory and honor. Thank you for these graduates and the call that you have on their lives. May they continue to seek you as they begin and embark on this new journey. Thank you, Father, for this university and the faculty and the staff at OBU who have taught, nurtured, and poured truth into their lives while equipping them to engage the world around them for the kingdom of God. Thank you for allowing us the opportunity to watch these men and women become who you have created them to be. We pray this in Jesus' name, amen.
On behalf of the faculty, staff, students, and the Board of Trustees of Oklahoma Baptist University, welcome to the 2017 Winter Commencement. Our invocation was led today by Dr. Kelly Young, Assistant Professor of Education and the mother of one of our graduating seniors. Bringing greetings today from the Baptist General Convention of Oklahoma is Dr. Anthony Jordan, Executive Director, Treasurer. Mr. John Fuller will be reading the scripture. John is as an employee of OBU, but more importantly, he's the father of one of our graduating seniors. And as a reminder that I am getting to that ancient age, he's also one of my former students. Our commencement speaker today, I'll introduce in a few minutes, is Dr. Anthony Jordan. Savannah Payne, Vice President of the Student Government Association, will present the undergraduate graduating class, and Mitchell DeCesar will present the College of Graduate and Professional Studies graduating class. Following the presentation of degrees, Lori Hagans will induct our newest graduates into the OBU Alumni Association. She is the Executive Director of the OBU Alumni Association. And then our benediction will be led by Mrs. Dawn Westbrook, Assistant Professor of Nursing. She is an OBU graduate herself and the mother of one of our graduating seniors. Commencement is a special moment in the life of a university. We gather today to recognize the achievement of those who have successfully fulfilled the degree requirements at Oklahoma Baptist University. The occasion marks the success of our faculty and staff in preparing students for lives of service and leadership. Commencement marks a new beginning for our graduates as they embark on the next stage of life. And while we honor our graduates, we also pay tribute to those who've supported and encouraged and prayed for them as they've continued their educational pilgrimage. And so to the parents and spouses and children of our graduates, to the grandparents and brothers and sisters and other family members who are here, we offer a special welcome. Graduates, faculty, and staff, please join me in honoring the family members of our graduates. OBU provides a distinctively Christian education. We're serious about our mission to transform lives by equipping students to pursue academic excellence, to integrate faith with all areas of knowledge, to engage a diverse world, and to live worthy of the high calling of God in Christ. Those most directly involved in fulfilling that mission are our faculty. Each graduate today is a testament to the successful investment of time, energy, teaching, and mentoring on the part of our faculty. Graduates, OBU assembled a faculty from throughout the United States and even around the world that you might have a first-class education. These men and women have sacrificed to be here, to serve here at OBU, because they're called by God to prepare you for your calling. Faculty, would you please stand and be recognized as we express our appreciation to you. Thank you.
Today I want to take just a moment of a personal word. For the last 22 years, I have, with rare exception, two times a year, participated in the graduation exercises of Oklahoma Baptist University, representing the Baptist General Convention of Oklahoma. It's been a great honor, and I've enjoyed every moment of it because I am so proud of this university, of the work it does, the investment it makes in students just like these that are graduating today. In April, I will be retiring from this position and therefore will not have this opportunity again, but I so appreciate Dr. Whitlock and those who've gone before him giving me that privilege. Graduates, today, I have the great honor of representing the Baptist Churches of Oklahoma, 1,800 strong, and we congratulate you. What an incredible thing to graduate from this university, one of the finest in the world. We as Oklahoma Baptists began our journey with this university in mind, and we are so proud of you, of this faculty, and of this university. During your time, we have invested millions of dollars in your education as Oklahoma Baptists through the cooperative program, and we are so thankful for that because we're sending you into a world armed with the good news of Jesus Christ, with skills that will carry you into the future. And we believe that you will make a difference in our world, a difference because you are followers of Jesus Christ and because of the education that you have received here. So on behalf of Oklahoma Baptist, congratulations to you and your family on this wonderful day, and may God richly bless you.
We are committed to the great commandment to love our God with all our heart, our soul, our mind, and our strength. Would you sing that commitment with me? Would you stand as we sing together, "My Jesus, I Love Thee"?
My Jesus, I love Thee, I know Thou art mine. For Thee all the follies of sin I resign. My gracious Savior, art Thou. If ever I love Thee, my Jesus, 'tis Thou. I love Thee because Thou hast first loved me, and purchased my pardon on Calvary's tree. Praises before thee I'll bow. If ever I love thee, my Jesus, 'tis now.
You may be seated.
Thank you.
bring you the scripture this morning, or this afternoon, from Psalm 16. Keep me safe, O God, for I have come to you for refuge. I said to the Lord, you are my master. Every good thing I have comes from you. The godly people in the land are my true heroes. I take pleasure in their friendship. Troubles multiply for those who chase after other gods. I will not take part in their sacrifices or even speak their names of their gods. Lord, you alone are my inheritance, my cup of blessing. You guard all that is mine. The land you have given me is a pleasant land. What a wonderful inheritance. I will bless the Lord who guides me. Even at night, my heart instructs me. I know the Lord is always with me. I will not be shaken, for he is right beside me. No wonder my heart is glad and I rejoice. My body rests in safety. For you will not leave my soul among the dead or allow your Holy One to perish in the grave. You will show me the way of life, granting me the joy of your presence and the pleasures of living with you forever. Thank you.
Our commencement speaker today is Dr. Anthony Jordan. Dr. Jordan has served as Executive Director Treasurer of the Baptist General Convention of Oklahoma since 1996, recently announced his plans to retire in April. His tenure of 22 years stands as the longest of any to hold that role in Oklahoma. Prior to his service with the BGCO, he served as a pastor for more than 28 years. He earned his Bachelor of Arts from Southwest Baptist University and both a Master of Divinity and Doctor of Ministry from New Orleans Baptist Theological Seminary. In 2010, OBU presented him with an honorary Doctor of Divinity. Dr. Jordan delivered OBU's Gaskin Lecture on Baptist History in October of 2016, focusing on the contribution of Falls Creek to Oklahoma Baptist history. And of course, one of his rich legacies will be Falls Creek. In September of this year, OBU presented him with the Herschel Hobbs Award for Distinguished Denominational Service during the Falls Creek 100th Anniversary Celebration. He and his wife, Paula, have two children, as well as a granddaughter, Lydia. I count Anthony as a dear personal friend. What he means to this university and to Baptists within our state and even throughout the nation cannot be adequately expressed. Before I allow him to speak, we've added one additional item to our program today. Each year in November, the Baptist General Convention of Oklahoma meets, and during my annual report, the J.M. Carroll Award is given. Keen observers last month noted that OBU did not award anyone during that presentation. We elected this year to recognize the recipient at our winter commencement. Dr. J.M. Carroll served as OBU's first president, helping establish the foundation upon which our tradition of excellence has been built. In honor of President Carroll and the legacy he left for generations to come, OBU annually presents the J.M. Carroll Award in recognition of outstanding denominational service in the state of Oklahoma. It's my privilege this year to award the J.M. Carroll Award to someone who has been a leader, pastor, preacher, evangelist, and friend of OBU. The 2017 recipient is Anthony Jordan. Please join me in congratulating Dr. Jordan and welcoming him as our 2017 Winter Commencement Speaker.
Well, I am exceedingly humbled to be recognized by this great university, a university that I love with all of my heart and so thankful for. President Whitlock, faculty, staff, and graduates and family, I just want to thank all of you for the privilege of being able to speak to you today, because this is a special day for you. For many of you, this is your last day on Bison Hill. As you get ready to go out into the world that God is sending you to make a difference, to make an impact for the kingdom. I know about these addresses, and so I'm going to use an economy of words and speak very clearly to you today. I really have only one point to make, And here it is. Character matters. Who you are is as important as what you do. Your talk will be hollow and cheap if your walk does not live up to your talk. And truly, your accomplishments will be left in a small pile of ashes to be blown away by the wind if you're not a person of high character and integrity. One needs only to watch the news reports or read your news feed to see the reality of my point. It's interesting that liberals and conservatives alike are moving quickly to an old truth in a new age. Character matters. People more and more are rejecting those who are one thing in the back room and another thing on the stage. You know, over the years, I have watched people rise like shooting stars in business, politics, entertainment, the academy, sports, and yes, even in religious circles. Tragically, too many of those shooting stars become falling stars. And why? Well, I would contend it is because sooner or later, what was hidden was revealed, leaving the person fallen, broken, and cast aside. The career, family, and friends in life were left in shambles. Yes, character really does matter. President George Washington wrote to his nephew that good moral character is one of the first essentials in a man. Without integrity and strength of character, success will be fleeting. It's important to realize that character cannot be purchased. Character is acquired step by step over time. A life of integrity is formed from the inside out. It's spiritual work of mind and heart. It's a combination of right knowledge and habitual practice of that right knowledge. During your time on Bison Hill, you have been instructed and trained in your area of concentration by some of the finest professors on the planet. They have pushed you and stretched you. And they've done so to develop a skill set that will allow you to compete on a high level in your chosen field. But your education has not been one-dimensional. OBU is not just about the head, it's about the heart. Our goal is to integrate your faith with your learning. We do not want to just develop you intellectually, but spiritually. Thus, your professors were just as interested in passing the baton of strong faith-informed character as in giving you a high-level skill set. They have sought to write on your heart a standard of godliness and holiness and godly character that will serve as the infrastructure of your success. The world can find a plethora of high-skilled individuals, but it has a much harder time finding people with high skills who have high moral character and integrity to match. Moral compromise and duplicity of character is found everywhere. Yet it is interesting that even in a godless world, they find duplicity unacceptable. The exposure of the moral bankruptcy in our culture has brought even the most arrogant to their knees. You see, people are no longer willing to keep silent and ignore repulsive behavior that comes from a flawed and broken inner core of the soul. They're demanding good character. It's not just a good leadership trait, but it is a requirement. I propose to you that even the world clamors to find a person who is genuine through and through and uncompromising in character. Indeed, we are all on a search for a man or a woman of godly character that will stand the test of time, who will finish well. The Lord set Jeremiah on such a search. He commanded him, "Run to and fro through the streets of Jerusalem. Look now and take note. Search its squares and see if you can find one person who acts justly and seeks truth." Our search is the same. We look for one person who believes right and behaves accordingly, a person worthy of our trust. So today, I want to challenge you as graduates to become that person of high moral character, that person of integrity. If you do, you will stand above the crowd. Respect and honor will come your way. In fact, I would propose that employers and customers, your students and church members will desire to have you on their team, and more than that, desire for you to be their leader. You will be like a valued diamond among pieces of glass. But let me be a bit more specific in regard to the meaning of character. I want to point to you to the biblical perspective recorded in the Psalms. In Psalm 15, the psalmist speaks of a person of uncompromised character as one who walks with integrity and works righteousness and speaks the truth in his heart. Some translations use the word blameless, while others choose the word integrity. But at the core of this statement is a clear concept of a person of outstanding character. The word for integrity has deep roots in the soil of everyday life of the ancients. In fact, John Trent gives us what I think is a very helpful insight here. He gives this illustration. As it is used in the Bible, the word integrity carries the meaning of being sound, complete, without blemish, crack, or defect. In that age, the age of the ancients, people relied on clay dishes, cups, and pots. And it took many hours for a potter to shape, fire in a homemade or handmade kiln, and cool the piece he or she was making. Unfortunately, with the uneven heat of a wood-fired furnace, cracks would often show up in the clay during the cooling process. For the true craftsman, that meant shattering the blemished piece and starting all over again. But for the unscrupulous potter, it meant filling in the cracks with wax and painting over the whole thing. Well, as you can imagine, the cracked vessel might hold up fine the first few times it was used, but especially if something hot was placed inside, the wax would soon melt and expose the defect. Well, that's why honest potters began putting the inscription "without wax" on the bottom of their pots. It was an inscription that meant this was a vessel that had been made skillfully, had been through the fires, and had stood the test of time. It was a vessel of integrity. When we say that godly people we respect are people of integrity, we mean that they have been uniquely handcrafted by God with special gifts. They've been tested by the fires of trials, and they've stood the test of time. In short, each is a vessel of honor of God without wax. But the real question comes, how can we develop godly character or a walk of integrity? Well, I've already intimated that character is developed over time. You don't just wake up one day and discover that overnight you were endowed with high moral character marked by integrity of heart. Character is like a muscle that must be developed and exercised regularly. Same thing is true, by the way, of character failure. Doesn't happen overnight. You don't just awaken one day and decide to steal from your employer or cheat on a contract, act immorally, or to take a bribe. No, character failure happens inch by inch. As one slides down the slippery slope of compromised character, the pace speeds up until inward character is revealed in outward action. If you fail to develop godly character day by day, your character muscles will atrophy. So how do we develop this godly character? Well, it's really rather simple. We do so by walking with Jesus and the Word of God day by day. This provides the spiritual exercise required to build a strong inner core of integrity. So I challenge you. Let the word of God flow over your life like a mountain stream over rocks and boulders. The word of God has the power to smooth the rough edges off your character and shape our character into the likeness of Christ. The constant flow of the word of God over us renews our minds and shapes our thinking and thus our character. As the character of Christ forms in our hearts, we become Christ-like, and our outward actions and behavior will reflect the character of Christ. Do you remember the words of Jesus that night in the upper room before he died on the cross? He said many things to his disciples, but there is one that sticks very clearly in my mind. You see, he knew his disciples were going to be tested by fire in the next few hours. And by the way, not just in the next few hours, but all of their life. And as you know, many of them died for their faith. He admonished them in this way: abide in me and let my words abide in you. It's here, abiding in Christ and his words abiding in us, that we gain moral muscle and mental integrity. The writer of Proverbs instructs us to watch over our heart with all diligence, for from it flow the springs of life. We'll mark it down. From a duplicitous heart flows hypocritical living. Hypocritical living leads to dishonor of you, your family, your friends, and more importantly, your God. But a heart filled with truth, that kind of heart will produce a life marked by integrity and righteous acts. This kind of character honors everyone around you. And most importantly, it honors your God. You're about to walk into a world that will try you by fire. You will be tested and tempted to compromise your beliefs and thus compromise your integrity. You'll not be able to withstand the challenges if you are not strong in the Lord and the power of his might. Character formation is a work of Christ in you. He shapes and molds you as you surrender to his will and his way. So today, graduates, here's my prayer for you. It is a prayer that you will become people of high character and uncompromised integrity, people who daily reflect the very character of your Lord and Savior. And if you do, you will shine in this world like a star in the darkest night, and you will achieve true success, not just in the eyes of people around you, but more significantly, in the eyes of your God. And that is true success. Congratulations on this significant achievement. And may God richly bless you from this day forward as you go into a world to be the person Christ has created you to be. God bless.
It is my honor as a Vice President of the Student Government Association of Oklahoma Baptist University to present to Dr. Whitlock, the Board of Trustees, faculty, family, and friends, Oklahoma Baptist University's Winter Class of 2017.
To preserve the significance of the OBU commencement, we respectfully request that you hold your applause and your outbursts as the graduates' names are called and as they walk across the stage. When all the graduates from each college have received degrees, we will honor them with our applause. As your graduate's name is called, we invite members of that graduate's family to stand in his or her honor as that student walks across the stage. Thank you. Will the members of the undergraduate graduating class of 2017 please rise? President Whitlock, the deans and I attest to the completion of all requirements for graduation by these candidates. I present to you the candidates recommended by the faculty of the university for the conferring of degrees.
members of the winter graduating class of 2017, by the power vested in me by the Board of Trustees of Oklahoma Baptist University, I hereby bestow upon you the degrees for which you have fulfilled requirements with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities that accompany those degrees. You may be seated.
Quilla Candace from the Paul Dickinson College of Business. Please come forward. President Whitlock, on behalf of the faculty of the Paul Dickinson College of Business, it's my pleasure to present the 2018 winter graduating class.
Thomas Ackernacht. Zachary Allen Clark. Grant Leroy Erickson. Tyler C. Fuller. Brandon Jared Garrett. Ryan Nathaniel Gay. Allison Jane Mock. Richard Cecil Palmer IV. Colin Van Spencer. Alexa Grace Tinenenko. Tucker Ray Yarborough.
Will you join me in congratulating the winter 17 graduates of the Paul Dickinson College of Business? Will candidates for degrees from the Warren Elm Angel College of Fine Arts please come to the stage? Dr. Whitlock, I present to you with pride the graduates of the Warren Elm Angel College of Fine Arts.
Lainey Marie Sue Barnes. Abigail Jean Bennett. Jason Berger. Lisa M. Drew. Allison Elizabeth Haynes. Logan Michelle Hayes. Lydia Caitlin Keller. Robin Jeanette Nicole Kylan. Angel O'Brien. Haley Faye Pearson. Nicole Ann Smith. Allison L. Speraza. Matthew Simon Westfall. Eric Yoder. Hunter Tiberius Zuhl.
Please join me in congratulating the Warren M. Angel College of Fine Arts graduates. Will the candidates from the College of Humanities and Social Sciences please come forward? President Whitlock, on behalf of the faculty of the College of Humanities and Social Sciences, it is my pleasure to present the Winter 2017 graduating class.
Kathleen Bamo. Kayla Lorraine Boaz. Nicola Brunn. Sarah Emily Combs. Ashley Nicole Cousat. Mackenzie D. Crawford. Eric Karan Darrow. Audrey Elizabeth Ellis. Sarah Forbes. Vivian Alexis Garcia. Brianne Nicole Greenhall. Madison Tate Hillis. Jackie Keach. Rebecca Jane Lee. Robert Meadows. Danny Lee Miller. Allison A. Mitchell Hill. Noah Joseph Nelson. Elena Nicole Nolan. Kevin Jose Almeida Ajedo. Renee Gabrielle Pete. Lauren Nicole Rezek. Ashley Rebecca Rogers. Audrey Lee Marie Rose. Ian Patrick Sims. Desmond K. Stiegel. Katrina J. Stevens. Stephen Dante Turner. Madison E. Vaughn. Sierra O. Veracruz. Gage Reed Weimer. Ashley Young. Taylor Ziegler.
Please join me in congratulating the students from the College of Humanities and Social Sciences.
Oh, yes. Yeah, sorry.
Would the candidates from the James E. Hurley College of Science and Mathematics please come forward? President Whitlock, on behalf of the faculty of the James E. Hurley College of Science and Mathematics, I present the winter 2017 graduating class.
James Burton. Caleb Munell. Summer Ray.
Would you please join me in congratulating the James E. Hurley College of Science and Mathematics winter 2017 graduating class. And will the candidates from the Herschel H. Hobbs College of Theology and Ministry winter 2017 graduates please come forward? President Whitlock, on behalf of the faculty of the Herschel H. Hobbs College of Theology and Ministry, we present to you the winter 2017 graduating class.
Corinne Bradley. David Dargo. Shelby Taylor Dillman. Dina L. Herring. Grant Hoover. Jonathan Christopher Stephen Ivers. Braden A. Norwood. Darius Edward Patrick. Nathan Shane Shipman. Weston Allen Bryant Young.
Please join me in congratulating the Herschel H. Hobbs College Theology and Ministry winter graduates. Among this graduating class are those students who have maintained an exceptional academic record. Students who complete requirements in the OBU Honors Program and students who completed honors thesis projects are approved by the Honors Committee and are afforded special recognition with the honor predicate with college honors. In your program, you will find listed the names of those students who have achieved an overall GPA of 3.40 or above who will graduate with the honors predicate cum laude. Other students are graduating with a grade point average of at least 3.70 and at least 60 semester hours completed at OBU. These individuals are graduating with the honors predicate magna cum laude. The highest academic recognition given by Oklahoma Baptist University is the honor predicate summa cum laude. To qualify for the predicate summa cum laude, a student must maintain a grade point average of 3.95 or above on a 4.0 scale and complete at least 90 semester hours in residence at Oklahoma Baptist University. Two students graduating today will be recognized for outstanding academic achievement. The university traditionally recognizes students who graduate with honors or who qualify with the honor predicate summa cum laude by investing them with the baccalaureate hood. Would those graduating summa cum laude please come forward?
Madeline Foote, Bachelor of Science, summa cum laude. Kaylin Rebecca Westbrook, Bachelor of Arts, summa cum laude.
It is my honor as a representative from the Oklahoma Baptist University College of Graduate and Professional Studies to present to Dr. Whitlock, the Board of Trustees, faculty, and family and friends, Oklahoma Baptist University's Winter Graduate Class of 2017.
And again, we ask for your assistance in preserving the significance of our commencement ceremony. And again, we respectfully request that you hold your applause as the graduates' name are called as they walk across the stage. Each graduate deserves to have their name heard as it is called, and each graduate's family deserves to hear their graduate's name called as they walk across the stage. When all the graduates from each college have received degrees, we will honor them with our applause at that time. As a graduate's name is called, we invite members of that graduate's family and their friends to stand in his or her honor as that student walks across the stage. Will the members of the College of Graduate and Professional Studies graduating class of 2017 please rise? President Whitlock, the deans and I attest to the completion of all requirements for graduation by these candidates. I present to you the candidates recommended by the faculty of the university for the conferring of degrees.
Members of the College of Graduate and Professional Studies, graduating class of 2017, by the power invested in me by the Board of Trustees of Oklahoma Baptist University, I hereby bestow upon you the degrees for which you have fulfilled requirements with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities that accompany those degrees. You may be seated.
It is my privilege to introduce Dr. Heath Thomas, Dean for the Herschel H. Hobbs College of Theology and Ministry. Will Dr. Thomas, Dr. Scott Pace, and the candidates from the Herschel H. Hobbs College of Theology and Ministry please come forward? President Whitlock, on behalf of the Dean and faculty of the Herschel H. Hobbs College of Theology and Ministry, it is my pleasure to present to you the Winter 2017 graduating class.
Curtis W. Irwin. Gary B. Nickerson. Scott L. Reed. Joe B. Sanders. Scott David Watkins. Benny Joe Lockler. Donald Dylan Sane. Rachel E. Sane.
Please join me in congratulating the Herschel H. Hobbs College of Theology and Ministry winner 2017 graduates. I would now like to introduce Dr. David Houghton, Dean for the Paul Dickinson College of Business. Will Dr. Houghton, Dr. Rick Martinez, and the candidates from the Paul Dickinson College of Business please come forward? President Whitlock, on behalf of the Dean and faculty of the Paul Dickinson College of Business, it is my privilege to present the Winter 2017 graduating class.
Gideon Asante. Dylan Everett Gardner. Robert Carney. Angelie de Patrie. Nanale Janko. Amalan M. Kaja. Lakshmin Narayanan Kalamutu. Venkata Charan Kantumuchu. Robert Marquardt. Matthew Ha. Simon B. Matema. Koi Meagle. Javi Sosa. Christopher Michael Sanford. Dimitro Smirnov. Brooke E. Webb.
Please join me in congratulating the Paul Dickinson College of Business Winter 2017 MBA graduates. I would now like to introduce to you Dr. Pam Robinson, Dean for the College of Humanities and Social Sciences, and Dr. Kanan Crane, Director of the Marriage and Family Therapy Program. Will Dr. Robinson, Dr. Crane, and the candidates from the College of Humanities and Social Sciences please come forward? President Whitlock, on behalf of the Dean and faculty of the College of Humanities and Social Sciences, it is my privilege to present to you the Winter 2017 graduating class.
Janet Ake. Megan Laurel Bam. Congratulations. You want the M. Ronald M. Bright. Kristen F. Calloway. Sally Copeland. Megan Cross. Mitchell G. DeShazer. Kenneth E. Ferguson. John D. Hollowell. Alyssa M. Lee. Brooke Elaine Runyon. James E. Smith. Amy E. Sutherland.
Please join me in congratulating the 2017 Marriage and Family Therapy graduates. It is my privilege now to introduce Dr. Lapina McHenry, Dean for the College of Nursing. Will Dr. McHenry, Dr. Robbie Henson, and the candidates from the College of Nursing please come forward? President Whitlock, on behalf of the Dean and faculty of the College of Nursing, it is my pleasure to present the Winter 2017 graduating class.
Elizabeth R. Baxter. Misty D. Gray. Abby M. Mann. Sheila Metzger. Julie Faye Nevins. Donna J. Prine. Fua Veng.
Please join me in congratulating the College of Nursing Winter 2017 MSN graduates.
Graduates, congratulations. You made it, and we're so very proud of you. It is my honor to induct each of you as life members of the OBU Alumni Association with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities which accompany this membership. I challenge each of you to be engaged alumni. Staying connected through the relationships that you have formed while on Bison Hill and also through your graduate studies. May you seek our God's guidance and direction on a daily basis. On behalf of OBU alumni worldwide, congratulations and welcome.
Graduates, from this day forward, you carry a special distinction. You are graduates of Oklahoma Baptist University. You studied at an institution that has sought to stand for Christian distinctiveness and academic excellence since its founding in 1910. We've sought to instill within you an honest awareness of yourself and the world around you, and to strengthen your commitment to Christ. We sought to equip you with the ability to think and with a knowledge base for sound decision making. We've sought to impart to you a heart to care and a spirit to attempt great things that will make your world a better place. You are recipients of a rich heritage. I charge you to move forward with hope and courage and to never stop growing, to never stop learning. As you commence this new phase in life, determined to serve others with an informed caring, dare to walk in faith, believing that God will use you to make a difference. Strive for excellence and quality in every area of your life. Know that what you do has consequences. What you do matters. Your life has purpose, and that purpose supersedes any job or career that you might pursue. I want you to remember that famous quote by Theodore Roosevelt that I share quite often regarding the man in the arena. Roosevelt said, It's not the critic who counts, not the man who points out how the strong man stumbled, or when the doer of deeds could have done better. The credit belongs to the man who's actually in the arena, whose face is marred by dust and sweat and blood, who strives valiantly, who errs and comes short again and again, who knows the great enthusiasms, the great devotions, and spends himself in a worthy cause, who at the best knows in the end the triumph of high achievement, and who at the worst, if he fails, at least he fails while daring greatly, so that his place shall never be with those cold and timid souls who know neither victory nor defeat. Graduates, I challenge you to live coram Deo. Live your entire life in the presence of God, under the authority of God, and to the glory of God. My hope, my prayer, is that you become men and women in the arena, who, marred by dust and sweat and blood, strive valiantly. I pray that when you fail, you pull yourselves up by the strength of Christ in you. I pray that your lives be spent in the worthy cause of Christian servanthood. I pray that you live your purpose out and dare to be all that God purposed you to be. I pray that you find yourselves in the company of men and women who dare to be different, who dare to be good. Attempt great things for God and for the common good, and know that your family on Bison Hill is cheering you on and praying for you each step of your journey. And now, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen. And so be it. God bless you.
Would you stand with me as we sing together?
Oh, be you all hail thy name, sons and daughters honor thee. May thy standard green and gold lead eternally. Proudly stand on Bison Hill, the winds so sky, alma mater, we will praise thee as the years go by. When the shades of evening fall through the hush of fading day, silent voices praise thy name, hearts look up to pray. May thy spirit guide thy sons, keep thy daughters true, loyal to bless all be you.
Graduates, congratulations. And my prayer for you is the same as that of Paul to the Ephesians. And let me read that to you. For this reason, I kneel before the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth derives its name. I pray that out of his glorious riches he may strengthen you with power through the Spirit in your inner being, so that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith. And I pray that you, being rooted and established in love, may have power together with the Lord's holy people to grasp how wide, how long, how deep is the love of Christ, and to know his love that surpasses knowledge, that you may be filled in the measure of all fullness of God. Now to him who is able to do measurably more than all we could ask or imagine, according to his power that is at work within us, to him be glory to the church and in Christ Jesus through all generations, forever and ever. Amen. Pray with me, please. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for the significance of this day and the celebration that it is. And I pray that you would go out with each student and each family that is represented here, and that the words of this scripture would plunge deep into their hearts and souls, Lord. Amen.